The touch of a doorknob, light switch, or phone triggers overwhelming anxiety in Gail Taylor.
It's as if someone has a gun pointed right here and says, you have to wash because you're contaminated.
For the last 12 years, Gail has spent a lot of time washing her hands. She suffers from a fear of contamination, one of the most common symptoms of obsessive compulsive disorder, or OCD.
OCD is characterized by recurrent and disturbing thoughts, ideas, or images, referred to as obsessions, and or behaviors that the person feels driven to perform, which are referred to as compulsions or rituals.
There's a pre-wash, and then the regular wash, and then each fingernail, the faucet has to be washed and rinsed.
How many times a day do you do this?
Anywhere from 8 to 200.
It all began 12 years ago with the birth of her daughter, Heather. Gail became obsessed with germs that might hurt the baby. That later evolved into other fears. Eventually, Gail's marriage broke up. She had to give up her career in teaching. Even her own daughter began to represent contamination.
I didn't want to touch her homework or her books or give her a hug.
To get a hug, Heather had to go through a cleaning ritual.
Yeah, I had to be virtually clean. I couldn't touch. I would take a shower and then I couldn't touch any of my stuff.
This man also spends a lot of time washing. He's Gail's fiance.
He puts up with a lot. He doesn't get to sleep in the bed unless he takes a shower. He has to sleep on the couch or the floor.
Why do you do it?
Well, I guess it's because it's love for the person, you know, and hope that things will be better.
All around the house, there is evidence of Gail's fears. The dining room is a holding area for both clean and dirty items. Then there's the downstairs.
Everything that gets contaminated that I can't wash or that I don't get to wash ends up down here.
And you have some pretty creative tricks for getting around down here.
Yeah.
What do you do?
Sterile doorknob every day.
Every time you do that with it?
Every day.
Why can't you touch the doorknob? What's
contaminated? In my head, it's contaminated.
You may think Gail is crazy. She's not. She knows her behavior is irrational.
It's essential to the diagnosis. So if they've lost the capacity to have insight into the excessiveness of their behavior, they no longer have OCD. They would be considered psychotic.
Dr. Goodman says some people may be biologically predisposed towards developing OCD. One theory is that a brain chemical called serotonin is out of balance.
Certain kinds of antidepressant drugs are currently being tested to treat OCD. They appear to somehow alter the chemical imbalance in the brain associated with the disorder. Some patients also improve with behavioral therapy, a technique in which they're exposed to the things they fear and forbidden to indulge in their compulsions.
Why don't we touch some of these things just like we do in the office?
This is the first time Gail Taylor has tried behavioral therapy at home. Therapist Joe Ricciardi is asking her to touch items and rate her anxiety level. 100 is the worst.
Where would you rate your discomfort?
It's about at least a 50.
At least a 50.
Yeah.
This is a card from, this is from Heather. Now where do you rate that as you hold on to it? Really hold on to it. Put your hands right over it. Good, good. Where do you rate your discomfort as you hold on to that?
It's about 80.
The more you can hold on to it, and you're doing really well, the more you can hold on to it, the quicker the discomfort will fade.
The session moves to the kitchen, where Gail is asked to touch her clean counter after handling items she considers contaminated.
It's crucial that you use it, just like a regular countertop, in spite of the discomfort that you feel. All right? Can you do it?
Maybe.
Maybe? Can you say?
I'll give it a try.
All right.
With therapy and medication, Gail is slowly breaking free from her prison of fear. One of her greatest improvements is with Heather.
We do engage in a little physical contact, I guess, now. But I was never allowed to do that when I was little.
Now I do have a lot of hope. My life right now is pretty productive, and it's almost normal. Almost.